I'm speechless. The Netherlands, what happened? What happened? Japan dominated this game. I'm lost. I'm so lost for words. I'm beyond lost. I'm more surprised. Wakatsuki might win the golden ball of this tournament. The guy was an absolute fiend. The number 9 for the Japan U17 World Cup squad. He just absolutely destroyed the Netherlands. Hijana Hover, the Liverpool Academy, not Academy, but the Liverpool player, alongside Ian Mattinson, and a lot of this Dutch squad. This Dutch squad was so amazing in the U17 Euros. Admittedly, they don't have all of the players that they had during that tournament, but you still expect them to come into this game, outpossess teams, find and create good chances, because the youth system that they have in the Netherlands, and that a lot of these players play in are absolutely amazing. And you'd expect them to get past a squad like Japan. However, Wakatsuki said, wait a second, hold on, let me just bag one goal, wait, let me bag two, let me lay off an assist for the third. Wakatsuki gets, I mean, all praise to Japan in this game. 13 shots in total, 5 on target, and they scored 3 goals. 5 on target, 3 goals. Absolutely amazing, absolutely astonishing that they were able to find a way to win this game such convincing fashion. Netherlands had 60% possession, 10 shots, only 3 of which were on target. With, to be fair, 1 shot off of the woodwork, it was kind of a diabolical shot as well. And it makes me, guys, it makes me feel so bad for the Dutch squad, because they were so hyped. I was so hyping them up. I watched the game between France and Netherlands in the U17 Euros just this last May. Netherlands were amazing. This Dutch squad was absolutely phenomenal. And France, with their own, respect, in today's U17 World Cup, were absolutely dominant against Chile. They were the exact opposite of what the Netherlands were. They were creating a ton of chances, and they were defensively solid. The Dutch squad, from the beginning, were just outmatched. In Japan, whether it's the speed, whether it's the individual talent of Joaquin Saka, they dominated them. They literally dominated in every single aspect. Japan, I don't know if I should even call this an upset anymore, because this game was it's not like it was like a 2-1, they score a goal in the final seconds. Japan, from the beginning of this game, were much the better side. And I give full praise to the youth set, for the youth setup of Japan. We've seen so many products coming out of that, not just the youth setup in Japan in general, but a ton of youth products. Hiroki Abe, obviously Take Kubo, which is the big one, among many other Japanese stars that are, let's face it, that are good, that are amazing. And with that being said, those players are still, what is it, only 18, 19, not even 20 years old. And they're performing now in Europe at some of the biggest clubs. And it just goes to show that the J-League, with their ideas, with their promotions of youth into the first team, that you have to play, it's 1 or 2 players under the age of 21 in your starting lineup in every game. That's an amazing feat, because all that does is that makes players who are young, gifted, technically sound, great scorers, great facilitators, great creators, it gets them recognition, it gets them notice, it gets them game time, which is the biggest one. If you look at the squad that this Dutch squad has, Hijana Hover and Ian Mattinson, who are some of their best players, they don't play at the senior level. Hijana Hover sits on the Liverpool bench. I believe he plays for the U23s for Liverpool, but Ian Mattinson as well, unable to get senior minutes. And it just, the Dutch squad itself, it's not lack of senior minutes that you can tell from this game. It's just there's literally a golfing class in the talent between the two teams. And Japan were just that much better because they play a lot of these players at this level, because they have a lot of players who are super duper talented that have been given the opportunity to do exactly what they want, and that's express themselves on the football pitch. And it was magnificent to watch. When you have 40% possession, 4-0, so you have the ball only, 2 out of 5 times of the game, 2/5 of the game, I'll put it better that way. and you still score three goals and you hold your opponent to none, hold them to three shots on target, hold them to only one hit off the woodwork. Keon Suzuki as well was amazing in goal. Zion Suzuki. I don't know why I said Zion. Zion Suzuki was absolutely great in goal. He was great at coming out, communicating with his defense. And this Japanese squad, it's not like they, attacked the wingers like the games earlier with Senegal and France, where they absolutely dominated teams on the wing. Japan were playing that ball right through the middle. Netherlands wanted to build up through the middle. They wanted to have Keanu Hoover, facilitating from the back or from that DM / center back role that he can play. They wanted, great 1-2 link-up passes, which is the Cruyff style, the youth style of play that they have. They wanted some amazing, link-up middle play, and Japan shoved it right back down their throats. They said, if you want to come at us right through the middle, be my guest. We're going to go right back that way. And it was only fitting that the striker Yamato Wakatsaki scored two goals basically from near inside the penalty area, because he had all of the time, all of the ability to do so. And it was absolutely amazing to watch. So Japan's stunning victory over the Netherlands. I think that game, I wish I would have been able to watch the Korea Republic Haiti game a bit more, because I don't know how dominant Korea were in that game. I don't know if Haiti themselves are disappointed to not have gotten points from that. But my goodness. Japan were arguably the most dominant, and not even the most dominant, it's that they took advantage of their chances. I think France so far have been the most dominant looking, actually. But they took the majority of their chances, they took them well, they capitalized on their opportunities, and they are 3 points to the better, plus three goal difference to the better, and looking brighter against one of the toughest opponents in their group, as they look now, I think, to push for home, push for winning the second game, coast in the third, in the 2017 FIFA World Cup, 2019 U17 World Cup group stage. God, I don't know why that was a tongue twister, but thank you guys so much for watching. Peace.